This is Richard from Benai, and I'm here with Johnny Whitney over the phone. I'm going to be asking him a few questions. Hey, Johnny, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. So where is it that you come from? Where do you reside right now?
I live in Seattle.
How's it out there? Is the music scene good?
Oh, yeah, it's great. I mean, it's always been good here, definitely.
Is there anything that has caught your attention that you would like to point out, like any bands or anything, or any new something new that's that you think might catch everybody else's attention?
In Seattle, I think my favorite Seattle like musician right now is Shabazz Palaces. It's like a dude from Big Ol' Planet, like hip hop. There's not like the most like keep up with current local music sort of person that, but. You know, there's so many bands here.
Well, being part of so many projects, has there been anything different in a writing style or more of like a trademark of what you've done with Burn Piano Island Burn? Because I know like in other projects that you've been in, like Jaguar Love, you quoted a line, I believe it was in Polarizing Red Wine that you quoted Burn Piano Island Burn as well. Is that more like of a trademark or is there a different way that you like to write, like with your style and stuff like that?
It's all pretty different. Those two records that you just referenced were about 8 years apart. So at like I was at a totally different point in my life when I was 20 than when I was 29 or 28 when I did that record. I mean, with Burn Piano Island Burn, the writing for me, like I didn't really have all that much to do with like the music on that record, with a few like small exceptions. Lyrically, and you know, it's just a totally different thing with the Blood Brothers and Jaguar Love, because you know, Blood Brothers is just like crazy, chaotic dynamo that's like constantly, like, you know, these songs that are kind of so parts that are constantly different and stuff like that. And so, like, writing vocals to that is a completely different beast than writing something that's like maybe a little bit more traditional.
Being in the Blood Brothers for 10 years, why did it come to a stop when you guys had like so many albums? Over that period of time, what was it, like 10 years?
Yeah, it was 10 years. It came to a stop because we just came to a point where, well, there's a lot of reasons, actually. Like, for me personally, like, I was having a lot of health problems were kind of, like, stemming from, psychosomatic, like, if I could be, like, you know, pretty honest about it, that I think had to do with just how I felt about what was going on. But also, it was just, like, we just came to a point where the thing that made us so good, in my opinion, is that there was not like one member of our band that had the exact same, like even in the same ballpark, like taste preference in music and taste preference in creating music. And it was a true democracy, like a five-way democracy. The like coming together of very, very different like schools of thought in terms of like what a song should be, I think is what made us really, really great. But it's also the thing that made it difficult for all of us, like on an emotional level, to come together and do something. And so like by the time we had been doing it for 10 years, and by the time we had gotten through Young and Steady, it was really draining. You don't really see that like from the music, because that record to me is like the most exciting, like spontaneous, like really fresh sounding thing that we've ever done, and like getting some perspective on it and like checking it out, not thinking about like how I felt but when I was like making it, it's like I don't get that from hearing it, but behind the scenes it was just really hard. And it was like we were all at a stage in our lives where it was like, you know, you're in your mid-20s and you're like, you know, the thing about being in a band is like you give up everything normal about being an adult, to be in a band, you know, you give up. For us, like, we were straight out of high school. We started on, like, a smaller level when we were 15, but, like, when we got out of high school, we basically, like, got $1 million record deal, and we're then, like, put on the road, like, for 9 months a year. And the thing is that you give up, like, you know, any kind of, like, higher education. You either do it, and you do it to its fullest extent, and, like, you know, take it to the grave, basically, or you kind of got to, like, let it go at some point, because there's not a lot of options once you've, like, committed yourself to being in a band. So it was, like, we're all just kind of, like, well, what are we doing? Like, what, you know, like, none of us are really, like, all that happy with, like, how we're all interacting on a personal level. Like, nobody was really having fun, which I think is, like, super important when you don't live a normal life. Like, you sit in a bus, drive all over the country, and, like, if you can't have fun doing that, like, something is dreadfully wrong. And it was tough financially. Like, we never had any money. Like, even when we were, like, traveling around and, like, playing, like, to, like, you know, sold out, like, 1,000-cap clubs every night, it was, like, there's just, being a band is, like, very expensive, you know what I mean? There was just a lot of things, all those things tied together. So there wasn't, like, one central thing. It was just kind of, like, we were all just kind of tired of it, and then people just started kicking around the idea of us breaking up, and then I was like, that's what we should do. And then that was it.
Yeah. This kind of genre, it's not really a rich genre. It's not like Led Zeppelin or Rolling Stones or anything like that, you know?
Yeah, I mean, there's certainly people that make money off of it, but it's really, like, fleeting and very difficult, you know? And that's not really, I mean, whatever. There's so many different ways you can look at, like, what you do as a musician. Like, personally, like, I'm at a point in my life where I don't rely on music for my, like, sole source of income. So, like, the way that my perspective on it is, like, when I'm approaching, like, making anything, it's much more rooted in what do I want to do rather than like what do I want to do to be successful. It's like what is interesting to me, what is like something that seems like it should exist that doesn't, rather than like how it just gets from my career or something like that.
Was there another reason why the Blood Brother called it quits? Because I had read that Jordan in another interview quoted, "I can't point one defining event. It was harder and harder for us to find that middle ground. Or we were all happy." He also quoted, "I couldn't imagine trying to work on another album with that band." Was there another reason why?
It's kind of just exactly what I just said, like, previously. It's like, it's not, there isn't one thing. It's not like somebody stole somebody's girlfriend and, you know. It's like, it was just a slow building tension. If you don't see eye to eye with people that you fundamentally, like, have to make every decision in your life with. I mean, it's like, you're like basically married to the people in your band, like effectively. It's like your second wife or girlfriend.
Yeah, that's true.
There was a point during the last year of our band where it was like every single major decision we had to make, it was completely polarized, and it just wasn't fun for anyone to be in that place.
Yeah.
Always had to be fighting. And like what Jordan said, like it just didn't seem like if we did keep going, if we did make another record, like we all kind of had this sense that it wouldn't be as good. You know, there'd be something, because there was that, like, the tension had grown to such a level that it just wouldn't have been counterproductive to, like, anybody's time. And it was also, like, we just wanted to, you know, like, I started doing some other stuff, they started doing some other stuff, and then the feeling of doing that other stuff outside the band was like, fuck, this is, like, I'm excited to do this. I don't view this as, like, this isn't hard, you know what I mean? It's not like when you step outside of the confines of, like, this tightly knit thing, like the Blood Brothers, and, you know, work with other people, and it feels right. It's, like, it's hard to not want to do what's easy. But then in hindsight, it's, like, that's what made us good. That's just, like, the fact that we were always fighting, that there was that constant conflict, that there was just that tension that was, like, always there, is what made our songs what they were, because it was, like, the most intense filter on everything creative, because everybody, you know, there was never any bullshit that made its way in, because there was always somebody that would catch it, basically. Which is why I think that, I mean, in hindsight, like, having had it been that way, then General Love was basically just, like, me and Cody, and we pretty much see eye to eye on almost everything. So it's like,
yeah,
that filter wasn't there at all anymore. And it's like, it's a different band, it's a different like style, but that's just not there. That special, like, you know, obviously the spark, the like thing that made us what we were, isn't there. Jaguar Love, I don't think it's there in past lives either. You know, it's like something that is like very, very rare that happens when like a group of people come together and like that happened with us happens. It's not something that you can plan, you know what I mean? It's just something that happens, I guess.
Do you guys still keep in contact? Like, all of you guys, Jordan, Cody, and everybody?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm.
If you guys were, would the Blood Brothers ever come back for a reunion show? And if so, would you guys do a tour with him? Or would you even continue with another album if it was possible?
I don't know. You know, I personally would, definitely. I don't know. We haven't, like, really sat down and, like, decided that was something that we all wanted to do. Like, everybody's kind of busy with doing other stuff.
Do you still have your clothing line?
I don't do it anymore. I stopped doing that about a year ago. Mark is doing this hip-hop group called Champagne Champagne, and Cody's been kind of, like, touring around. He was touring this thing called Telekinesis for a while, and then Morgan's been in 40 Foxes. So everybody's kind of, like, you know, all doing other stuff. We haven't really, like, ever sat down and had a talk about, like, do we ever want to get back together, but I definitely would. To what extent, like, I, you know.
What about Jaguar Love? Are you guys going to release anything soon?
Cody, like, we have a new record. Cody wrote it. It's pretty big. Like, all the music is entirely recorded. We had a baby this year, and, like, I've been doing kind of, like, other non-music stuff. That's kind of.
Oh, congratulations.
Oh, thanks, yeah. So, like, yeah, I mean, the long term, there's a record, it's written. It's like, I told Cody, basically, like, I was at this point, summer, where I was just into, like, the Clash and the Misfits, like, that's all I really had any desire to look into. And so I called Cody up, and I was like, hey, can you just, like, write, like, what if you just, like, took a week and, like, wrote a record or something like that, and just made that the next album of record? And, he did. It's recording, and it's just kind of waiting on me,
can't wait for that, huh?
Yeah, I mean, we kind of just, like, we came to a point, like, me and Cody, after we did three tours off all the jams, and it was just kind of like, we didn't, like, break up or anything, but we were just kind of like, well, this is kind of like...
Like a hiatus kind of thing?
Well, it wasn't really that, but, like, okay, I think we've taken this as far as it can really go for this record.
What about your acoustic mix? Will you make another one anytime soon?
I want to, yeah, I just haven't really had a ton of time to, like, get into it and make it, like... the way that I want it. So I've been doing like a lot of like outside like design and like just like programming work for the past year, just taking a break from like that part of my life. So I definitely am gonna get back into it. I just haven't gotten there quite yet.
What about another book? Because I purchased The Mermaid and the Actor, and I really liked it a lot.
Yeah, I'm working on it, definitely. I have this problem of, like, wanting to do more stuff than the game can actually do in his life. So, like, I have a lot of things in the pipeline that I'm working on.
Neon Blonde, are you guys on hiatus?
That wasn't really a thing that was ever going to be a band. After Crimes came out, I just had a bunch of songs that I had been working on. Like, I just kind of, like, basically, like, held up in my house for 2 months, and it was like I had just learned how to use Reason. So I was, like, really into making, like, you know, songs around, like, programmed beats, and it just didn't really seem appropriate for the Blood Brothers.
Yeah.
And I wanted to, like, have the experience. I was meeting George Lloyd's singers and Blood Brothers, and I've always been a musician and, like, playing instruments and stuff, and there wasn't a spot for me to do that in the Blood Brothers just because, you know, Cody and Morgan are so, like, just such, like, virtuosos at what they do. So I did that just basically as a, you know, just did out of my system, basically. You know, had Mark play too on some of the songs because he did fucking awesome drumming. And that was kind of, that was meant to be what it was.
I know you featured in, like, a lot of, well... From what I'm aware of, you featured in quite a few other artists' songs. Is there anything that we can expect in the future?
Yeah, I'm doing a ton of stuff with the Castlevania. I'm the chief of DJ Los Angeles. I'm actually going down there 2 weeks to write some music with him. I started doing, there's this band called Arsenal. It's cool, man. Like, it's a totally different, like, they contacted me through Crystal City, like, out of the blue. And they're basically, like, the two instrumentalists that they make these records in Belgium where they just write all the music, and then they have all their songs have guest vocalists. They get people from, like Africa and China, like these world music singers, but they also get, like...
Oh, it's really diverse.
It's super diverse, yeah. And, like, they'll have, like... They have this, like, French rapper on their last record, and then, like, they have, like, people, like... I don't know if you know Sean Smith, he has this old, like, sort of, like... He's not a band called, like, Grab. It was, like, really big in the 90s. And then he's, like the main guy in the band, like, basically, like, one day went to his promoter, who promotes clubs in Antwerp, Belgium, was like, hey, any, like, cool music I should check out? And it was, like, right after Blood Brothers was right there. He gave him my record, and he really loved it. And so he contacted me to do some songs, and it was supposed to just be one song, but then it just kind of, like, turned into three. And so it's, like, it's really cool because they're like, fucking... So they have so much momentum behind them, but only in Belgium. Like, he went and played, I played a show with them in front of, like, the most people I've ever played for in my entire life. It was, like, 70,000 people.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. They're really, really awesome people. They're super talented, and, like, it was just a really, like, fun experience because the music, like, obviously, the music is, like, not, it's very different from anything I've ever, like, been a part of. So it presented as, like, a really unique challenge, and I think it ended up being really cool. So, yeah, I'm doing that. I'll probably do another song with them this year and go out and do some shows in the summertime. And like I said, I have two songs I did for the Castlevania record, and I'll probably end up doing at least one, if not maybe two in a while.
Well, that's all the questions I have for you. Is there any way, like, people that are listening that can get a hold of you? Like,
okay. I mean, my Twitter hash is just Johnny Whitney.
Yeah. All right, then, cool, man. This has been an exclusive with